Hey, what's up YouTube? It's me, Amon the Mayor for the Amon the Mayor Show, and welcome back to Pokemon Colosseum from the Nintendo GameCube. And we're going back to Mount Battle, and now we are on the 41 area. Wait, I don't know. My brain don't worky. I don't know. So our first person is Funnel Man Orsky. He must be Russian. So he sends out Flaffy. I send out Flaffy. Holy crap. How will this turn out? Well, I electrocute it. Will it survive? Yes. It does takedown. It missed. I don't know. The thing with Pokemon Colosseum is that I completely underestimated Mount Battle. I mean, I guess it extends Colosseum's life. It extends its playtime. Every area it's about half an hour maybe. So it extends its life, no doubt, but it's so tedious. Just battle after battle after battle after battle, and but then again, the reward is worth it. I believe at this point, or when this game was released, the reward was worth it. I mean, a spoiler. At the end of Mount Battle, the 100 one, pro tip, this is not the battle, this is not Mount Battle, the one in game. This is the one when you go through the menu and you go to the battle area stuff from the menu from the start of the game, not in game. Complicated, I know, but that's why I put the whatever, right? It's not the one that you walk around and blah blah blah. At this point in time, the Pokemon Advance games were already out, and that included Ruby, Sapphire, Emerald hadn't come out yet. Neither had Fire Red or Leaf Green at the time of Colosseum, and so completing the Pokédex was kind of a challenge because you couldn't get the Johto Pokemon, and so what Colosseum's whole purpose was about was introducing the Johto Pokemon to you so you can capture them and complete your Pokédex. And thus, yeah. And the reward of Mount Battle is Ho-Oh. So, because at this point, old version had not been remade. It was still only available for the Game Boy Color, and you could not trade any Pokemon, you know, from the Game Boy era to the Advance era. So that was just not possible at that point. The technology that we had from the Advance era to the DS era, that technology just was not possible. So at this point, this reward was rewarding. It was extremely valuable and, yeah, worth it. Totally worth it. At this point right now, it's not. Because Heart Gold is out. And that's exactly why they even made Pokemon XD. Is because they put Lugia in it, and you could not trade Lugia, and that was the only way you could get Lugia. Legally. You could always, you know, cheat and get a Game Shard or something like that, I suppose. But yeah. And so that was the whole purpose of the game. But And that's probably why there hasn't been a third game in development in terms of the Or series. Which sucks. Because since they remade all the old past games, there's no real need to continue this story, because what kind of Pokemon are they going to put in? I suppose they could make another Order series and put, you know, Hoenn Pokemon. But that wouldn't really make sense, because they could just do that for the next Pokemon games, which would be Pokemon X and Y. They could just fill that also with or Hoenn Pokemon. Makes sense. And plus, you can still transfer from the advanced games to your DS and your DS to your 3DS. So, yeah, that was the whole purpose. And you couldn't get whatever. That's just my little ramble about that. But I remember getting this game. This game is very old. I remember this game being so excited. And I remember that I had no idea what it was about. But when I started playing it for the first time and actually thinking, wow, it's about, wow, you get to capture these Pokemon and then purify them, and then it's yours, you can do whatever. I was thinking, holy crap, that means you can actually capture... Goron is his name? I don't freaking know. The Pokemon that are featured in the cover, right? The mascots of Ruby and Sapphire, right? But no, you can't. You can only capture the legendary dogs. Although Suicune kind of seems feline, and so does Raikou. They seem feline in a lot of ways. The only one that kind of looks like a dog is Entei. And, interestingly enough, a lot of my games still have this thing, the thing where you can, you know, fill out and Melon, so you can have a subscription to Nintendo Power. But unfortunately, as we all now know, Nintendo Power is no more. What a sad thing. And, now that I've been talking about absolutely nothing related to what's happening on the screen, let me explain what's happening. The opponent has managed to defeat all my Pokemon except for Hitchcock. And with Hitchcock, I decided to do Psybeam. My weakest psychic attack. Wobbuffet, of course, is now confused. It does Miracle. Oh. So close. Now, that's very dangerous, because there's always been an instant where Miracle has absolutely destroyed me, but thank goodness it did not do it this time, because I'm not entirely sure what happens when if you lose. So yeah. And yeah. Oh yeah, this guy has a team entirely made of water Pokemon except for Pikachu, so that kind of contradicts what I said. And it is now 11:55. This video is about 30 minutes long. So here's a question. Now, because now I'm really not talking about the game, and I'm really wondering, how did I commentate over my two first games? I really don't know how. But anyways, what are you guys playing at the moment? What are the games you guys are playing right now? For me, the games that I am playing right now, proactively, I wouldn't count Pokemon Colosseum as a game that I'm proactively playing. The game games that I am playing right now are mainly Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon. Can I get a yay yeti? So that's the majority one. That's the one that I'm really getting into. And I love Luigi's Mansion. I mean, I remember that being one of the very first games that I've wanted for my GameCube. I've always been a big Luigi fan, and that usually tells you that I was always player number two. But what that doesn't tell you is that I might be a younger brother. The thing is that I'm the oldest, right? Technically, I'm the oldest. In reality, I'm not. I have an older brother, but he's my half-brother, so technically I'm the oldest because I only have one real brother and he's younger than me, but blah blah blah, whatever. So when they announced Luigi's Mansion, I was really excited, and I pre-ordered that last year. Like, I think in the earliest I can pre-ordered it, I pre-ordered it, so. And I got it. And it actually released when I was in vacation, so I got it almost the next day after I got home, I guess would be the right word. So I was really excited. And and what else am I playing? Well, in terms of Wii U, I've been using a lot of Netflix lately, and the show that I'm watching is Top Gear. Mainly because I'm not satisfied with what Comcast is delivering to me on demand. They had this thing recently of Watch-a-thong weekend, and it was boring. So I went on Netflix, and they have all the seasons of Top Gear up to season 2, and that's freaking amazing. I love that. And I've been watching nonstop, so that's the thing that I've been watching a lot. And a game that I recently had to turn in to Gamefly was Paper Mario. That game just wasn't doing it for me. I don't know. I could have reviewed it, but I really don't like reviewing bad games. Oh my god, I'm gonna get a lot of thumbs down for that, and a lot of hate for that. I mean, it's not a bad game, it's really not. I just don't feel that. It's not for me. It's not a game for me, and I don't like reviewing games that are not, they don't grab my attention. The exception being 007 Legends, which I reviewed. Two games that I've started but have not exactly finished is the Arkham City and Assassin's Creed 3. Arkham City, I've beaten the main game. I just need to get back into the habit of doing the side missions and the DLC. And the Assassin's Creed, I'm not even halfway through with it. I just don't have time. I have a lot of games, I just don't have time. Nintendo Land, I barely even touched that. I did a few games, but I just don't have time. I have GameCube games, don't have time for that. I have Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I have to get everything back that I lost because my old Wii broke and I had everything on that. And yeah, god damn. So yeah, it's gonna be a while before the next LP, believe me. Unless I LP Assassin's Creed 3 or Batman Arkham Asylum, but I doubt that I will. I'm also planning to buy or get Call of Duty Modern Warfare Reflex Edition. Because probably maybe towards the end of this year, I want to LP that game as well, because I did Modern Warfare 3 for the Wii, and it was a very brilliant game. I don't know why people complain about Call of Duty. I really don't. I get maybe because it comes out so frequently, but whatever. bought Pokemon Battle Revolution again, because I want to do videos on that. And, someone asked me if I was going to ever LP Black Ops and then do Black Ops 2. The problem with that is, because I like addressing problems first, is that how they're presented, they're not presented in a LP-friendly way. Let's just say that. And, yeah. There's a lot of games that I could LP. I have a lot of games that I could LP. But anyways, something that I like is that I have a Blu-ray player. And I bought Lethal Weapon on Blu-ray because that's one of my favorite series ever. It looks fantastic. And I pre-ordered Lincoln. I got it already. And I haven't watched it yet because I don't have time. Anyways, this is our next battle. He has a Magnemite. I just do Flame Wheel. Go! So, I know on the videos that I did post, the recent videos of me unboxing Pokemon trading card game cards, there was supposed to be an annotation of a preview of a series that I'm going to be bringing. I haven't even made that video yet because I don't like the finished product of said series that I'm working on. I don't like it. Just looks very amateurish, and I don't like it. So I am gonna have to refilm everything, unfortunately. So yeah, that's just an update on that. And, yeah. Well, technically, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 Blu-rays. Two Blu-rays. 4. Anyways, here we have an epic battle between son and father. Or is it daughter father? I don't know. Yeah, son. I mean, son father. Cyndaquil versus what he will become. I could LP on the front line just to mix things up. But that game was hard as balls. Wait, that makes no sense. But anyways, our next battle is 48, 46, I don't know. Yeah. She sends out Bagon, and I do Psybeam. And I defeat it quite easily. I'm a bomb. And I think she sends out Cacnea? No. That weird thingy. And then she sends out Goldeen. Again, another Goldeen. So many Goldeens. I've seen 2 Goldeens today. And I defeated it quite easily. And then finally, trainer number 47, Body Build Out. Rawless? Oh, you're gonna fall. again, he doesn't have any Pokemon that would be stereotypically attributed to people who build bodies. Whatever. I don't have Pokemon that are necessarily attributed to people who steal things. There's two. And Chiminko is not a ghost type, is it? I think it's just psychic. Yeah. That sucks. Yeah, it's just like... And I do psychic. An Abra sent out. And Staryu is sent out. You know, I've always had a soft spot in my heart for Staryu. Unfortunately, I probably wasn't feeling that same sentiment when I was battling it, because it probably didn't take return pretty well. And try as it might to raise its defense, it's not gonna last really long. Words, they don't work. Anyways, Hitchcock. We just finish it here, and yeah. Next battle is cool trainer Rosno, or Reznov, with boobs. Boobs. All grass types. Grass types. I don't know how I said that. But anyways, I keep saying anyways in videos. I don't know why I keep saying that. I should stop saying that. You probably know who I'm gonna send out first. Man, they really wear those short shorts really well. I'm so lonely. Alcatraz, go! Burn it. Flame Will, go! Skip Bloom. There's actually something really funny about Oddish. Well, something funny concerning Oddish in Pokemon XD. Which, by the way, Jaywitz has just started an LP of Pokemon XD, Gale of Darkness. Link in the description, I guess? I don't know. Fine. Now you'll get a link in the description. Why not? He's awesome. And the battle's already over. Holy crap. Chaser Mandev. Oh. What a name. I guess he has a pretty diverse team. I guess. I wonder why they call him Chaser. Delibird, as in... works in the deli. Actually, Delibird is probably named Delibird because he delivers stuff. Since his color scheme kind of reminds me of, is reminiscent of Santa Claus. Interesting that I kind of talk smack about it when he actually brought Athena's HP down. Or maybe that was just me. That was probably just me. Doesn't matter though. Tentacool. I think an underrated Pokemon, perhaps. I don't know. Tentacool's defense rose. And it has an Oran berry. Huh. Psychic. Huh, I'm being ballsy. Not really. Splunk. It's sent out. Man. With all the interesting conversations that I just had over the past 25 minutes, technically 21 minutes and 30 seconds, I don't know what to talk about. I guess I could talk about an LP, the future of this channel. I suppose that I had already had decided that I had I already had an idea for an LP in my head. It would be like a reboot of an old LP that I just couldn't finish because my Wii broke. I think maybe there's still old episodes. And hey, we got to the area leader. It has the three starter Pokemons of Johto. Wonderful. Well, I pay no mind to that. But I think I might do an LP, and I think I am gonna do it. It's probably, actually, you know what? I think I am. I am gonna do it. I'm gonna write that down. LP this game, and I spelt it wrong. There's no team. There's ice. But anyways, first clue is. It's a Wii U game, and okay, so clue number one. It's a Wii U game, not an exclusive, so that's clue number two. Not an exclusive, and clue number three, currently no DLC. That is all that I got. Those are my clues. Probably a little too blank, too obvious, but whatever. And I think we just won. Hey ho! Yay! I'll always remember the battle something something, I don't freaking know. And we won! Yay! I love winning. Alrighty then. So, my name, if you did not know, is Armando Romero, and this is the Armando Romero Show, and this has been Pokemon Coliseum for the Nintendo GameCube, and I'll see you next time.